ערב טוב וברוכים הבאים. אני שמח ונרגש לפתוח את פסטיבל הסופרים החמישי במשכנות שננים, ומודה לכבוד הנשיא על שהוא מכבד אותנו בנוכחותו. מבחינתנו, זוהי בכלל חובה לקיים את האירוע הספרותי המרכזי בישראל, למען הסופרים ולמען הקוראים, ואנו נמשיך במסורת הזאת כאן במשכנות.
Stories can make us better human beings by telling us a different story of ourselves and of the world than the one we already know. Dear writers, I ask you, keep telling us stories. Your good stories, yes, could save our lives.
Let me ask with a very simple and bold question. Do stories have a special unique role in areas of conflicts like Ireland, like the Middle East?
If you look about what happened in Northern Ireland, and the human heart in conflict with itself, the great joy of our peace process is that peace can finally vote. How did our peace come about? Storytelling, the ability to listen to the other, was at the heart of what became our proper peace process.
By retelling a story, we create a movement in something that became rigid. And maybe this is the reason why people need literature, because so much parts of our world are being formulated in rigid, thick, stereotypical language. But writing, and if you allow yourself really to be immersed in the personality and in the history of the person that you give voice to, you know, suddenly you are free. Suddenly you stand and you in front of an arbitrariness that has paralyzed you before you started describing it. Suddenly you are not a victim. And believe me, Colum, for me as a Jew, not to be a victim, even for a minute, it's a great thing.
When we are talking about telling another story, we are talking also about writing another man's life, writing another one, another character. And I would like to ask you, when you are writing a character, is there a certain point when you say to yourself, hey, I have it, I got it?
There is a moment of magic when you find a character. It takes a lot of work. What you need to do is you need to capture a voice. And what you do is you go in and you chip away and chip away. And a writer has to be like an athlete, in fact. You've got to get out there every single day and kick the ball and kick the ball and kick the ball in order for the ball to eventually go in the goal when you're playing on the field. And that's what it feels like to write a character. And these characters are within us. And when you discover them, you never actually lose them.
When you allow yourself to diffuse, to melt into the different suggestions of your character, suddenly you really realize how many persons are within yourself, persons you didn't know about at all. But then when you gave them voice, and if they responded, then suddenly you become so rich. Every character that I wrote that seemed to me not real, later I found out not only that she's real, but she's such an authentic part of myself, even though if in the beginning I really rebelled against the need to write her, but then I saw how relevant she is to me.
One of the beauties of fiction and literature is that we can wake up in the morning and look in the mirror and say, I don't want to spend all day long with you. You can also do that as a nation, right? Yeah.
Well, I feel we've just begun, really, but the time is done, and you should sing now your Irish song, I think.
In Dublin, the most fair city, where the girls are so pretty, I first set my eyes on sweet Molly Malone. As she wheels her wheelbarrow through the streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh.